بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters and fellow viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We're back at it again with another episode of One Man Army, The Life of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Last episode, just to recap a little bit, we spoke of the dialogue between him and his father, the conversation, the heavy conversation that took place of his father Azar and the son, which is Ibrahim alayhi salam. We knew that his father said, "Wahjurni Maria, get out of my face, O Ibrahim alayhi salam. I don't want to hear none of this da'wah. I don't want to hear none of this preaching about not worshiping the idols and not worshiping the statues." We spoke about why he refused to listen to Ibrahim alayhi salam. Therefore, after this incident that happened, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quotes Ibrahim alayhi salam that he swears by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam swears by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and says, "I will surely plan against your idols after you have turned and gone away." He swears to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like, "I'm going to take care of this after you guys leave town. I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm gonna make a difference," right? Today's episode, he makes a difference on this festival day, right? So what is this festival day? What would happen on this festival day? Now, they actually used to hold this annual festival each and every single year for the new and upcoming idols, mashallah, right? They used to have these new idols every single year. Oh, we got a premiere of these new idols you got to worship. So every single year they used to premiere these idols to the people of Babylon, and everyone used to go out. It was a joyful time, it was a celebration, and then they would bring these idols back to their temples and have it laid out so they can worship them. Now, when they asked Ibrahim alayhi salam to join the festival, he replied on Surah Saffat, "Faqala inni saqim." He said, "Indeed, I'm sick. I don't want to go. I'm not feeling too well," right? And then they turned away, فَتَوَلَّوا عَنْهُ مُدْبِرِينَ. So they said, okay, they're not going to ask him, you know, if you're not feeling too good, all right. They didn't think too much of it. And Ibrahim alayhi salam stays all alone in Babylon. They go to the outskirts of Babylon, celebrating their premiere of that year's idols, right? So they left the festival while Ibrahim alayhi salam stayed back. And then he goes to the temple where they left the idols. And we all know this famous story, right? He goes to the temple where they keep the idols. Keep in mind, the scholars of tafsir say that Ibrahim alayhi salam was roughly 16 to 17 years old. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he goes to them, faragha ila alihatihim, right? He goes to their gods and he actually presents them food. He gives them food. You look at the da'wah, Ibrahim alayhi salam. He brings them food, right? And he says, ala ta'kulun. He says, "Y'all want to eat?" Right now he's speaking to the gods, right? And he's like, you guys want some food?" Right? And obviously the gods are just statues. What are they going to say? Right? So he says, "Malakum la tanṭiqūn." He says, why aren't you speaking? Right? "You guys want to eat? I got food. It's delicious food. How come you guys ain't saying nothing?" Right? So he's like, "Malakum la tanṭiqūn. How come you aren't saying anything?" Faragha 'alayhim daraban bil yamin. He turned towards them, striking them with his right hand. So he begins to smash these idols. Ibrahim alayhi salam begins to smash these idols. The entire time while he is smashing the idols, he was asking them the same questions. "Malakum la tanṭiqūn. Speak up. You're not saying anything to defend yourselves. I'm smashing you with this axe or a hammer or whatever he had in his hands." He was smashing them and he's saying, "Speak up, say something, defend yourselves." Right? The idols had no choice. Obviously, it's a piece of wood or it's a piece of, you know, concrete or what have you. It's not going to speak back and defend itself. So Ibrahim alayhi salam goes at it and he begins to smash these idols. Now, the people coming back from the festival are now, you know, in a joyful mood. And Ibrahim alayhi salam smashes all of these idols. But the beautiful thing that Ibrahim alayhi salam does here, which I'm probably sure that you and I wouldn't even think of doing, Ibrahim alayhi salam leaves the big idol, right? He leaves it alone. He doesn't touch it. And he actually hangs the very instrument that he used to destroy and smash these idols. He hangs it on the shoulder of the big idol, right? And he walks away. All of the debris, you can imagine all of the dust and the cloud and the temple. He walks away with a smile on his face. All of these people coming back, they're happy, they're joyful. Oh, we got new idols for this year. They come back, they open up the temple doors, they open it, and they're shocked, right? Imagine their eyes, right? This is disrespect to their gods, okay? This is disrespect. They're shocked. They see just debris, concrete, wood, all over the floors. And dead on center, right where they're looking at, they see the biggest idol that they have on its shoulder is the very instrument, the very tool that Ibrahim alayhi salam used, but they didn't know it was Ibrahim alayhi salam at that moment. They're going around, they're murmuring, they're speaking to amongst each other. They're saying, who would even dare to do something like this? One of them says, he said, they actually say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala records it, قَالُوا مَنْ فَعْلَ هَذَا بِآلِهَتِنَا إِنَّهُ لَمِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. They said, who has done this to our gods? We want to know who did this, right? We want to know who did this. He is amongst the wrongdoers. They say, some of them say, قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا فَتَى. We heard of a young boy, which is around 16 or 17 years old. We heard of a young boy, يَذْكُرُهُمْ يُقَالُ لَهُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. We heard of this young boy. He used to go out in the streets of Babylon speaking trash of our idols. I think he, either it's him, or he knows who did it, or his army or his gang or whatever it may be. It may be him. And let's go get him and summon him to this temple. So they bring Ibrahim alayhi salam, and you can imagine the smile on Ibrahim alayhi salam's face. He's not afraid, subhanAllah, right? Ibrahim alayhi salam is not afraid. And he goes and they begin to shout at Ibrahim alayhi salam. قَالُوا أَنْتَ فَعَلْتَ هَذَا بِآلِهَتِنَا يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ. Did you do this to our gods, O Abraham? Did you do this to our gods, O Ibrahim alayhi salam? Ibrahim alayhi salam beautifully answers him. He says, قَالَ بَلْ فَعَلَهُ كَبِيرُهُمْ هَذَا فَاسْأَلُوهُمْ إِنْ كَانُوا يَنْفِقُونَ. He says, rather, ask Big Dog over there. Ask the big idol. Ask him if they even speak. And they're thinking, the people that are in the temple, wait a minute here, Ibrahim, this boy got a point. They can't talk, right? He's right here. For a quick second, they knew, wait a minute, Ibrahim is right now. They can't talk. And he's asking us to ask the big one. The big one should know if they know how to talk. The big one has the axe or the tool on his shoulder. He should know. Therefore, their pride and their arrogance got in their way. Although they knew deep down inside in their hearts that the truth, that these idols can't speak for themselves, can't even defend themselves. They knew that, but their pride and their arrogance, you can see the dangers of pride and arrogance. Likewise, the dangers of pride and arrogance in the people of Ibrahim alayhi salam, that it covered their hearts from the truth. And they said, you know what? Make a fire. Right? Their idea, mashallah, their right idea was ubnu lahu bunyanan, right? They said, make a fire, construct for him a furnace, and throw him in the blazing fire. Tune in the next episode on what happens to Ibrahim alayhi salam and this fire that they build. Anything that I said that was good was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that I said that was bad was from myself and the shaytan. Tune in on the next episode where we'll be discussing what happens to him with this fire and the incident between him and the fire. I'm pretty sure most of you know, but let us dive a little bit deep, inshallah, in that series or in that particular episode. Wa jazakumullahu khair. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our good deeds and forgive us for our shortcomings. Wa jazakumullahu khair. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.